Hey everyone! It's a beautiful day to learn. In this channel, you will be learning about machine shorthand. So, if you're interested, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell button for notifications. Hey everyone! It's a beautiful day to learn, isn't it? Every day is a beautiful day to learn. But before we proceed, I think it's safe to say, to ask, how are you? Because I think it has been a while since I uploaded my last video, and here I am. So I think that's what matters most. So yeah, since the last time I uploaded a video, a lot of things had already happened in my life. The death of my father-in-law, Odette, and then on December, I gave birth to our second child, and he is now 1 year and 6 months. Indeed, time flies so fast. So, I guess that would be all. So, I hope that you're also doing fine there. And let's continue learning. Let's enjoy learning machine shorthand. All right, let's start. So, in this video, we will learn about Lesson 5, Keyboard Familiarization. It's a continuation of the last video that I uploaded. So that was about lesson 4. Still, we will be using the Standard Real-Time Theory series. So this is a double character representations. We have the vowel I and the initial side. Now, before we proceed with the discussion proper, I think it's safe that we review the keyboards. So we have here initial keys or initial consonants. So those are found on the left side of the keyboard. These are initials S, T, K, P, W, H, and R. So those are initial keys or initial consonants. Then we have the final keys or the final consonants. Those are final F, R, P, B, L, G, T, S, and final D, Z. Then we have vowels or the vowel keys, vowels A, O, E, and U. So again, notice that not all alphabetic letters are represented by single keys on the shorthand machine because some require the pressure of two keys simultaneously. All right, so looking at the vowels, we have only vowels A, O, E, and U. So among the 5 vowels, it's only I that's missing because I is represented by vowels E and U. So whenever you see vowels E and U, that means vowel I. So in order to write vowel I, you will have to type vowel I using your right thumb. You press it simultaneously or together. Then what appears on your screen or in your paper will be vowels EU, and that would mean vowel I. All right, let's proceed to initial side double consonants. Now, there are again letters that is not present on the machine shorthand keyboard. Now, these letters are represented by 2 consonants. For example, for initial D, it's initial T and K. For initial B, it's initial P and W. For initial L, it's initial H and R. For initial F, it's initial T and P. And lastly, for initial M, it's initial P and H. So how are you going to write these letters? You have to press these letters or keys, initial consonants, simultaneously. Same with the vowel I. You will have to press vowels EU all together or simultaneously. So for initials TK or initial D, you will be pressing on the crack. You will use your left ring finger. For initial B, you will use your left middle finger. For initial L, you will use your left index finger. For initial F, you will use your left ring and middle finger. And for initial M, you will use left, middle, and index finger. So again, you press them simultaneously. Sorry. All right. So these letters, the home position, the finger position can be found in my previous videos discussion about machine shorthand. I guess that was in the first series of machine shorthand video that I uploaded last time. I'll just put the link above for you to review, or if you want to review about the finger position or the home position. All right. Now let's proceed. I have here an example. So you can see on the left side, it's the lesson that we had earlier. It's about the double consonants and its equivalent letters or equivalent initial consonant. Now, looking at the right side, we have here the word or the stroke initials TK, vowel A, and final D. That would mean dad. Okay, so the initial TK there stands for initial D, and you follow the rest. So that's DAD, so dad. Next, you also have initial PW, vowel A, final D. So initial PW stands for initial B, so that's bad. Next, we have initial HR, vowel A, final D. Initial HR stands for what again? Yes, that's initial L. So initial L, vowel A, final D, that's lad. Then initial TP, vowel A, final D. Initial TP is equivalent to initial F, so that's a fad. Lastly, we have initial M, vowel A, final D. So initial M, that's initial PH, so that is mad. All right? So it's very easy, right? I just have to memorize. We'll just have to put in our mind that these letters or these double consonants are equivalent to a certain initial consonant or a certain letter. Right, now you already knew how to read those double consonants, initial double consonants. Let's proceed to activity number one. So I'll be giving you time to answer this one. We have 5 items here. So you write down your answers there. So first word, you write your answer. Second word, you write your answer. Third word, you write your answer. Fourth word, you write your answer. And then fifth word. All right, I hope that your answers are correct. Okay, we will be checking your answers now. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let's reveal the answer. For the first item, it's rib. Notice that initial R, vowels EU, so that's represented by vowel vowel I and then final B, so that's a rib. Next, we have the word bit. The second item is, or the second word is bit because that is initial PW. Remember that initial PW is initial B. Then we have vowels E and U, that is vowel I, and then final T, so bit. Next, we have initial TK. So that is initial D, and then vowel O, final L, so that's doll. Next, we have initial TP. Initial TP is initial F. Yes, correct. Then we have vowel A and final T, so that's fat. Next, we have initial PH. So initial PH is equivalent to initial M. So that's initial M. Or initial PH and then vowel U, final G. So that is mug. Now let's proceed to activity number 2. If earlier I gave, for activity number 1, I gave you the strokes and you read it or you translate it into English words. This time I am giving you the English words. Then you give me the strokes. So what will be the strokes of these 5 words? We have dip, far, bar, leg, and shift. All right? So I'll be giving you 5 seconds, or you may pause the video to give yourselves more time to answer. So in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's reveal the answer. There you have it for the first word, dip. So it's initial TK, vowels E, U, and final P. So again, initial TK is left ring finger, then vowel I is vowels E, U, using your right thumb. Then final P is right middle finger. So you press them all together, then there you have it. You have your dip, the word dip. So same with far, then we have bar, then leg, and then shift. So for shift, still it's initial SH, then vowel EU for vowel I, then final F and T. I believe you got it all correct. So congratulations for answering it all correct. All right. So in order for your skills to be improved, you have to practice also typing or writing using your improvised machine keyboard, or if you have machines at home. But I cannot give you the dictation here. I'll be making a separate video wherein I will be presenting all the dictations for all the lessons in this book. So we'll start with the dictation about the initial consonants, the final consonants, the vowels, up to the last lessons. So the dictation will be on a separate video. All right. Now we have an assignment. All right. So this assignment, what you're going to do is to transcribe or give me the English words of these 5-item assignment. All right. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, an application of the lessons that we just learned in this video. Don't forget to comment below your answers for items number 1 to 5. And those who will get correct answers for all the items will be given a chance to win 30 pesos worth of load or GCash. All right, so I guess that would be all for this video. I hope that you enjoy learning machine shorthand with me, and see you all next time. Thank you so much for learning with me. It's a beautiful day to learn indeed, and see you all next time. Bye. God bless.